Welcome to Connor and Boone at the Boondocks. Here with me, I have my co-host, Boone, or Eli Klein. So today, what are we going to be doing, Eli?
Today we're going to be doing some ice fishing here on a local lake, and just trying our best to catch some panfish.
Yeah, so that's our goal, and we'll keep you guys updated along the way. We're going to do a quick outfit change, though. All right, now that we got our equipment on, we're ready to go ice fishing. We got the good old cloggers on, so we don't get wet, because it is a little bit wet out there. Eli just dropped his glove. That's probably going to suck.
All right.
But Connor forgot his glove, so it doesn't matter.
I dropped my other glove.
Oh, and he dropped his other glove. So we're going to get out there, and we're going to start fishing.
But I'll give you guys the MTV Cribs tour while we're here. So that's the fish finding sonar. That's the hole where I'm gonna catch a big one out of. That's the hole where Connor's probably not gonna catch anything out of. And yeah, that's the place, my fine establishment, my humble abode.
All right, now that we've set up for everything, Eli, explain what these things are.
We're setting up some tip-ups for big fish. So essentially, this is just like a stagnant line. You drop it down with a live fish or a minnow on the bottom of it. Today we got shiners, and you hope that a big old pike comes on by and takes it from it.
Hopefully you guys can see this, but this is a vexillar. There's a bunch of little circles that you can see my jig right there. It's bouncing up and down.
I probably started fishing when I was a little kid, as long as I can remember, at least with my dad and my grandpa, just going down to the river and fishing. But ice fishing, I never really got a chance to do until I got all the equipment later.
Jigging for ice fish, essentially a jig, is, you can't see it from where you're at, but there are these little pieces of metal called tungsten. And tungsten is just a super heavy piece of metal, and then they have a little hook on it, and you put your bait on the little heavy piece of metal with the hook, and it drops it all the way down to the bottom super fast because it's heavy. And when you drop it all the way down to the bottom super fast, it bounces off the bottom and the fish see it, and they're like, I need that.
Got it, Connor.
I still got it.
You got it, Connor. Set the
reel.
Set the hook and reel.
Yeah.
Oh. Reel. You got tension still?
Yep. He's on there.
Keep tension the whole time.
I can
drop your rod.
I do.
Connor? Oh, the littlest freaking bluegill known to man.
The smallest bluegill in the whole entire world, guys.
Oh, Lord.
And we're just going to let it go.
Grab the
vexillar. Alright, I got you. These things are tiny.
You hadn't caught the one that was even smaller.
Ugh, these things are like tiny. But you know, a fish is a fish.
It's like that one SpongeBob news anchor dude.
Today we are reporting from news dude.
Yep.
Fishing on our way back to Platteville here. It was a mildly successful day, I would say. We caught some fish, did a good job, but we didn't catch anything too big.
Yeah, I caught three little small bluegill, but you know, that's a good start to a series if you ask me, because we didn't get skunked.
Exactly.
And that's a good, and Eli said he's been skunked a couple times this year already, so, which kind of sucks, but it got really dark out, so we couldn't record too much more, and the ice started getting super watery, so we felt like leaving, and we're just gonna head home. And we appreciate you watching this first episode of this three-part series.
See you next time for bank fishing.
Be on the lookout for that, and we'll see you next time.